Hi, this is Susan Haynes, and I would like to talk about rotations in a binary search tree. These rotations are known to us because they're fundamental for AVL trees, and they also are used for various trees like splay trees, red-black trees, things like that. So let me talk about rotations. Before I do that, let me talk about binary search trees. And a binary search tree, of course, is a binary tree. So I'm just going to make up a binary tree right here. Let's suppose I have a node right here at the root, and we'll put a node which is less than it and a node greater than it. And then down here, I'm going to have some subtrees that I won't specify what the values are, but I'll just draw a picture for placeholders for them. Now we know that with binary search trees, when I do an in-order traversal of the tree, my data elements that I use to sort on the tree are going to come out in sorted order. So if I were to do an in-order traversal on this tree, I start at the root and do the left subtree, and so I start at this root and do this left subtree. So the first thing that I visit will be A, and then I do its root and 1. And then the right subtree, so all the elements in the right subtree in their proper sorted order, and then N2, and then this subtree right here, so that'll give me C, and then N3, and D. Okay, so this is my tree in sorted order, and I notice that this right here is the root of this tree, so I can actually parenthesize this so that I can see what the structure of the tree is that I'm dealing with, right? And so we parenthesize these things just for convenience for us to see how the tree is structured. Now, this is the sorted order right here. So I could write this out also sorted order. So and choose this element to be the root instead, so that I would have this to be the right subtree of this root right here, and this would be the left subtree of this root right here. Now, obviously, I can choose at this point the only data that I know about. I mean, I could pick any of these elements inside any of these subtrees, but right now I don't know what those data values are. So I could pick either of these to be the next root down of this right subtree. So let me just pick N3 to be the next root down. So that's described by this tree right here. Okay, so I can write out what this tree looks like. The root is N1 and its left subtree is A. And the right subtree is this thing right here with its child being N3. And N3's left child is this thing right here, so that child will be N2. Then N2 has two subtrees, B, see the B, and C right here. And then N3 has a right child, which is D. So what rotations basically tell us is how we can go from one binary search tree to another binary search tree, maintaining the order, but changing the structure of the tree.